guys, as you can see, they've opened up the mouth.
Biden. Not this
one. So as I was saying earlier on over there, like the pesticide, the algicide, they spread on the water. The hyacinth is dying, so that means what else is dying, because the hyacinth can take stuff, but that was probably bad poison. And as you can see, you know, like the pieces of the
nutrients.
Yeah, go see, talk about the sand. Yeah, what color is the sand?
What's brown color?
Yeah, what's in the sand?
Pieces, what's it called again?
It's algae.
Algae.
Growth.
Growth.
Slime.
Algae growth slime.
On an estuary mouth.
On an estuary mouth.
As an estuary mouth.
Yes.
This is normally all white sand. You see how dark gray, you see how dark the sand is there. See how brown, you see how brown the sand is there in the front pieces there. What color is this here? You see how brown, you see how brown the brown slime is. You see the hyacinths. You understand now about nutrients.
Yes.
Look at me. An ecosystem, right? Especially a mouth, right? It's supposed to be clean sand. The prawns and the little microscopic zooplankton, they eat all the debris. But if you overload that system, right, they can't cope. And what happens to those little prawns and that little zooplankton and that? They die. Bless you. They die. Now what shows you that the zooplankton, bless you, have died? What do you see down there?
The flamingos are not as pink as they usually are. And over there.
White. You see how they filter feeding in the silt? They're looking for zooplankton.
But they're not finding any.
But now look at these flamingos. They're white, right? Mm-hmm. They've come up here, okay? So now the sea has also given this estuary some more zooplankton, microscopic organisms that come to settle on the mud, right? You don't normally only see those flamingos down there. You'll see a few flamingos down there. You don't normally see these little flamingos right here on the prawn banks, right down here. These ones are normally up the river, right? They're normally upriver, right?
They're quite pink. They're pink, but they're not.
Their legs. Look at their feathers, right? So now these flamingos are normally quite sensitive, right? But they're so. They're not afraid of us now. Flamingos, normally they fly very quickly, quite wild, okay? But now they're so hungry, right? So they're setting themselves up. So they actually tolerate us being so close here. Because they're so hungry. And what makes it, why you can say that they're hungry? You can see they aren't pink. So that means the zooplankton that they normally get, with your creatine inside there, it gives them their pink color. Okay, same as the Black River. They were cleaning the river the other day, and I see there on there, help up or something. Say, oh, look, the flamingos are tolerating us. They know we're doing something good for them. It's not that they're doing something good for them. They're so hungry. Their feathers are so white, right? The ecosystem is very bad, and they're not getting enough food, right? So when they're not getting, like the polar bears there in Russia and that, what are they doing? They're coming out of the Antarctica. Antarctic up there, and they're coming right into the cities and the dustbins. So they're not worried about man, you understand? So they're setting them up so they get diseases. It's not the normal food, you understand? They shouldn't be eating that food, because in the wild, you get your food chain. So your food chain starts with your plankton and then your zooplankton. Now that all gives omega threes and good nutrients in the food chain. Like Eskimos don't get heart attacks. You know that? Eskimos don't get heart attacks because they eat the food chain up there is very good. So there's a lot of omega threes inside there. See, so you actually, even the probiotics in the polar bear, now they'd be eating Kentucky Fried Chicken, I don't know what else they got up there, but I'm just saying, so they're eating things that they shouldn't be eating. So their whole gut system, right, can be complications. So you see how you actually can hurt the ecosystem, because they shouldn't be eating that stuff, you understand? It's not good.
Yeah.
Now you understand the flamingos. You can see how white those flamingos are. I mean, even those legs, they could have just flown in now. Look at their legs. Their legs aren't even pink. Look at that. That's hectic. Eh?